Hello, in this video, I will show you how EM circuit cost simulation using RFPro and DOE in ADS can help you to achieve a robust RF design. RFPro can be used for RF module, RFIC, MMIC, and RF board designs, allowing users to focus on design rather than setting up EM. It addresses common issues in RF EM designs, including manufacturing effects, designs with multiple technologies, and an increased number of RF components. Among its advantages to enable an RF design, this video I will show how it can account for manufacturing process effects with or without a PCell. It enables variations in etching effects, alignment between layers, or material properties. By this method, you don't need to have a PCell. It is easy to add variables on the fly and set up the sweep. You can leverage this feature to do your EM circuit cost simulation. Furthermore, ADS provides statistical analysis feature. It can enhance the yield with parameter variations. Our solution can assist you in identifying problematic parameters and interactions between parameters. The visualization of the relationship between variables and the results, along with the yield percentage, can provide insight into a design's expected yield with certain manufacturing tolerance. Furthermore, our solution provides specific value ranges for achieving the highest yield, giving you more details for optimal design. By utilizing this flow, your design can become more tolerant to variations, resulting in high yield. With our process integration and statistical analysis, you can make informed decisions faster. Now, I would like to give you a demo. First, let's start with the layout. Click this button and create a layout. So over here, you can import a file, either a board file or MCM file through ADFI or other formats listed here. I'm directly drawing a coil in ADS layout now. Once the layout is ready, then you can assign geometry parameters. Click EM component parameters, and you can type in the parameter's name. Then enter the value. Click Add. Choose vertexes you want to move. When you click Apply, you can see the change of this size. And click OK. Now this layout has one parameter included. And then you can save it and close it. Then you choose a new layout. So here you drag the first one into this blank layout environment. Then you have this layout as a PCell. RFPro can assign ports automatically, which is a big benefit for RF design engineers. So if you define the ports locations in the layout, then it will appear in RFPro automatically. Or you can define the ports in RFPro GUI directly. So let's assume that this PCL has already defined ports in the layout. Let's go back to cell 1 and choose File, Customize PCL. Under Artwork Type, you can choose Parameterized Subnetwork PCL. Click OK. And then choose two pins. Put them into the input of this coil. And then save it. Then we can go back to cell 2. Choose this PCL, right-click your mouse, choose Component, and then update the component definitions. Now you can see that the two ports location have been assigned here. By clicking the RFPro button, the RFPro GUI will appear, showing you information such as the substrate, the cell, the name. So I would like to change this cell from the circuit to layout, so you can directly see the geometry in this environment. Then let me expand it and choose the pins that's defined in the layouts. Right click your mouse, create one port per pin. Then you have ports here. You don't need the expert knowledge about how to define the excitation, the pulse types, those kind of advanced knowledge. Now we have pulse ready, and then we can set up a parameter. So we know that we have one parameter in PCell. Let's check it by right click the cell one and choose design parameters. We see that the coil W is here. So how about if this is not a PCL, but just a purely layout you import into your RFPro, then you are still able to set up parameters for your package analysis. So under options, click that and then choose process variations. Now, you can set up variables for process variations with regard to stack-ups, etching bias, the alignment of masking, and the thickness of each layer. So this is the global values that can be applied to all layers, but you still be able to specify a certain layer and define it for each layer. The same thing applies to materials. You can define conductivity as well as permittivity. Now I can go to setup parameter sweep, enable perform parameter sweep, and then I can add the parameters I have assigned. So you can add one or more sequences with different combination of variables. This gives you flexibility to use subset of your variables to fine tune your design. So here I just use one sequence and then you define values for each of them. So once you have this set up, then you're finished with parameter sweep setup. Then you can choose your preferred simulator. Here we have three simulators, momentum RF, momentum microwave, and FEM, which is a 3D EM algorithm. And then you have to set up frequency plans. Here I set up from 0 DC point to 5 GHz, all right? So now you are ready to run your simulation. So here you are able to launch your simulation by clicking Run, and then check your results by clicking Add Parameters. Here it will take several minutes, so I just have results ready here. So in the pop-up window, it's not just Add Parameters, but all other common parameters. Here I just choose inductance as an example. So you can check your results with all these variables just set up. And furthermore, you are able to enable your EM circuit cost simulation. So you can just click Generate Sub-Circuit. Wait several seconds. And then you're able to have all your EM data transferred, variables set up in your circuit environment. So by using this step, it's easy to combine with other simulation templates in ADS. For example, I will show you a DOE simulation in ADS that uses EM parametric data from RFPro. Please check the next video with part 2.